Hello all, welcome to the next session of self-management skills. In the previous video lecture, we learned that why managing oneself in order to achieve our target is very important. Otherwise, we may not be able to manage our time and achieve our targets, and we may end up blaming our circumstances, our destiny, and our luck. So it is very important, irrespective of whichever domain we are, that we should learn how to manage ourselves, and that technique is nothing but your self-management skill. This self-management skill, whatever we are going to have, we should set the targets, we should be smart. Here, SMART means S stands for specific. The target should mention what are you going to finish. Let us take an example of a student. Today is March 10th, and the student says that by April 15th, I'm going to finish the five main topics of mathematics of my class. So then the target here is set. That target should be measurable. And this M here is related to the above concept, that it is specific. It is time related and it is topic related also. Five main topics by April 15th. But here, if somebody says that I'm going to achieve this one by April 1st week, it is not possible. So achievable in the sense that consider your ability and circumstances that allow to achieve them. It does not mean that you're going to overburden yourself and say that within 12 days, I'm going to finish, which is not possible. Then if we don't achieve, then we are going to blame the circumstances and other situations around us. So make it achievable. And the next one is R. R stands for realistic. The real ability or your ability in the given time frame. So not only should be achievable according to your ability, it should be realistic also. Suppose the health issues are there, certain unprecedented circumstances occur to you in your life, then that time you'll not be able to achieve it. So it should be achievable plus realistic also, given the time frame. You cannot say today is April 10th, and by April 15th, I'm going to finish all the five topics. It is not possible. Suppose I'm already 100 kgs. Within 2 months, I'm going to lose 50 kgs. Is it possible? It's first of all not achievable, and it's not realistic also. It should be time bound. Why we should say that our target should be time bound? Because if it is time bound, it brings a sense of discipline inside us, and it also helps to measure our progress. So keeping this in mind, if we have our targets as SMART targets, then the concept of controlling also comes over here. Controlling means analyzing the achievements at set intervals, looking for gaps, refining the plan, finding better ways to achieve the goals, ensuring self-discipline, handling distractions, motivating oneself. Controlling ensures to not only do what we have planned, but also continue to do it in future also. So if the targets are SMART, then we can have control on ourselves as well as our targets also. Because we can see whether we are able to achieve according to the set intervals. Initially, we saw that about daily targets, weekly targets, monthly targets, all these things. We can look for gaps. Why we are not able to achieve that? But then we can change our plan accordingly. What is the best way to achieve the goal? Whether there is any lack in self-discipline, whether are we getting distracted by external factors or internal factors, how to motivate oneself, so all these things. So controlling not only helps what we are doing, but it is going to help us to continue what we are supposed to do. That is, our main agenda is to do what? To achieve our target. And that achieving the target is one of the main concept of self-management skill. Then along with this controlling, we can have the concept of reflecting also. Reflecting will give us the exact picture of where we are and what we want to achieve. What is the distance that we have to cover in terms of time or in terms of abilities or in terms of strengths or weaknesses? All those things, self-reflection gives us a time to think and reflect on our strengths and weaknesses and helps us to achieve our target. Okay. So the next concept that we are going to learn is what are the tools for self-management? If you want to manage ourselves in the best possible way, there are three tools. They are self-motivation, time management, and responsibility. In order to be able to achieve our targets, viewers, we should know that we should be highly self-motivated. When is the self-motivation going to come? If we have self-realization. So self-realization is the initial step leading to self-motivation. And it suggests that we should begin managing ourselves. If we realize our strengths and weakness, then we should know how to, then we will know how to begin the managing ourselves. So if we know how to begin managing ourselves, obviously we're going to go for self-management skills, that is self-motivation. Next one is time management. There are three important concepts under time management, that is priorities, time allocation, and self-discipline. So priorities means, suppose I have 5 tasks to do. Prioritizing means what? Making a priority, which is the first one to be done, which is the second to be done. So in that case, I know which has to be given the first preference and which has to be given the second preference. In that way, I can manage my whole day in order to achieve the target. And once I know my priorities, I can allocate the time. If I allocate the time, then it is going to lead to self-discipline also, that, okay, 1 hour is for this task, half an hour for this task. So this itself brings in a sense of self-discipline. And the third most important thing is responsibility. Once you know that you're responsible for doing this task, the sense of responsibility and constant reminder that we have to do certain tasks to achieve our goals is a must. We should keep on realizing that, okay, this is my responsibility and I have to do it. So whenever you have certain responsibilities, share it with others, with your family, with your friends, with your colleagues, so that you get the required support, the motivation from others. Suppose you're trying to lose weight, or suppose you want to score 100 out of 100 in all the subjects. So you get motivation from your friends and family and parents and siblings that, okay, see, this is your goal. You have to achieve this one. And it's not that they're trying to pull you down. They're trying to motivate you. So if others motivate, we get a sense of responsibility that, okay, this is the responsibility that I've taken. I have to achieve it. We should not procrastinate. The meaning of procrastination means that we have decided something to do, but we are doing something and we are trying to postpone what has to be done now. Suppose today in the morning, I have to work out one exercise. Instead of doing that, I start painting. That is not what's supposed to be done. So if we keep on postponing our task at the scheduled time, what we are supposed to do now, then that concept is called as what? It is called as procrastination. And how not to procrastinate? Recreation is very important. Recreation also is very important to keep us focused. Every day, whole day, we are studying and we are not playing, or we are not getting entertained, we are not talking with your friends, then that is not going to help achieve our targets. In fact, that is going to pull you down. That is not going to motivate you. So along with the targets, you should have the pre-decided recreational activities, because again, I'm repeating to all of you that change of work is rest. If you keep on doing one task, you'll get bored. So change of work, that itself will give you some physical or mental rest, and then you get recharged, you get re-energized, have some recreational activities, step out, listen to music, do some exercises, watch some entertaining movies, inspirational movies, again, come back to your desired goal, what target you have set. In that way, you can achieve all the goals that you have set. So what are the three tools of self-management, students? It is self-motivation, it is time management, and responsibility. In the next session, we are going to learn how to build our self-confidence in order to achieve this target. Okay, till then, take care. Bye-bye.